So my best friend texted me this picture. This picture is on Facebook. Nobody told me they was in church taking pictures and they were gonna put me on Facebook. I'm just saying. How rude. But your girl is fly anyway. I was just praising the Lord, having my best life at church. And somebody decided to photograph it and put it on Facebook. On Facebook. You know I went and put it on Facebook, Instagram, and Snapchat. Cause yeah.
Good morning, y'all. I'm going swimming again today. I got good news and not so good news. Which would you rather hear? I'm gonna say the not so good news. So, my truck is decelerating when I go up hills. Just when I thought I was gonna be able to pay this truck off and be able to zip around my town and the neighboring states, that meant Florida and Mississippi. I'm like, I can go to Pensacola. And I had just said that this morning to somebody. And I can roll to Pensacola whenever I want to. And I can roll back to Mississippi whenever I want to. I just don't want to drive my car further. And wouldn't you know, when I got in the car this evening, coming home. Well, yesterday evening. Coming home. It's real hilly where I live at. And my car is like, I don't want to go up this hill. And it'll fall under 20 miles an hour trying to take a hill, depending on how high the hill is. Y'all, I'm going to cry. So, I had, my fluids wasn't low. I was hoping that my transmission fluid was low. I can go buy some transmission fluid. And I done caught the problem before it's bad. Transmission fluid ain't low. That Betty just don't want to take a hill at all. So, I text my best friend. She sent me a guy's number that would come over here and check it out. Adventures Online dating a new guy that I've actually hung out with a little. Works on cars and stuff. So, he said he'll come and check it out when he get off work today. Which is yay. Even if he can't fix it, at least he's going to put it on some type of machine that will detect exactly what is wrong with it. So, that's still a yay situation for me because I need to know what's wrong with the bed, you know. What else? Okay, the good news. Which I may not see as good news, but I've decided to do the 7 baby steps to financial freedom and getting completely out of debt. And in doing it, I realize I'm only in debt to, well, 4, but really 3 entities. My Visa card, my Lowe's card, my Firestone card, and then I owe about 3 more payments to the aforementioned truck. So, baby step number 1 is to have $1,000 savings fund. I'm working on that now because emergency savings. Because I depleted my emergency savings over the summer for the aforementioned vehicle. That's why I don't want to put any more money in it, so I'm going to let the guy tell me what it is he thinks. If it's something that don't cost that much to fix, then I'm going to fix it. If it costs a whole bunch to fix, I'm not going to do it because I took almost all of my emergency fund and threw it into that car this summer. And if it's another 5, 4, 3 that I got to put into it, I'm not going to do it. But that being said, looking at what I owe as opposed to how I could pay it off and doing it the step way, it doesn't look that daunting. It looked daunting before, but all I was really thinking about was the Visa bill. The Visa bill is outrageous. It's not out of control, but it is outrageous. Like, it's, for me, ginormous, because I don't do debt like that. But I'm looking at all of my bills, and I'm like, oh my God, I got 12 here and 13, no, 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 12 here and 17 there, but I don't. 12 was how much credit I had with Firestone. But what I actually owe with Firestone is less than 8. Lowe's, I want to say 18 was how much I had, but what I actually owe is 11. So, the plan, only got 3 payments of the car, so it'll be paid off by November. And then I could take the car note money and throw it on that Firestone. So Firestone should be paid off. If I pay the minimum balance to the other 2 cars, Firestone should be paid off by January. And then, that would mean, no, Firestone should be paid off. Yeah, Firestone should be paid off by January. And then, the goal is to have Lowe's paid off by March. And then, concentrate on paying the Visa out. Because that'll be the only outstanding debt that I have. What I'm going to do as well, I got these little services. In December, I'm going to cut my services off. Meaning, I'm going to cut my Hulu off. And I'm going to cut my music off. Because that right there is $30. I can throw at another entity. But I got to wean myself out. So, 1st of January, I won't have either one of those services. So, that'll be some more money that's not coming out of my account. And another good news is I'm learning how to jailbreak my phone. So once I jailbreak my phone, it's going to be a lot of other stuff I can do with my little old iPhone. I'm going to try to do that today. I'm kind of nervous because I don't want to get no kind of bug on my phone, but I don't watch the jailbreak video 8 times. I downloaded the app. It's just not a matter of me just actually doing it. But yeah, anyway, that's the bad all the way to good news. The bad, okay, good. That's how we just did it, but I have it all fit now. I'm going to hang one of these. This one probably I'm going to hang on my wall, and this one I'm going to leave on my desk, and every time I make a payment, I'm going to mark it on there. And the way I'm doing it so I can see exactly what I'm doing is at the top I put down what I actually owe. Then I'm subtracting the interest. Like at Firestone, my minimum payment was $27. Now, I wasn't paying the minimum payment. I was actually paying double the minimum payment because that's, I thought that would help. And it did help, I believe. But the minimum payment was $27. The interest was $13.91. So that meant I was only really paying on this debt $13 a month. Like, for real, how fast I'm going to get that paid off? They were getting over because they're getting $13 and I'm paying $13. You see, you feel me? Okay. Lowe's is the worst corporate out of all of my entities because, well, no, it's not. Well, Lowe's is bad, but it's not the worst. My credit card is actually the worst. But Lowe's minimum payment was $38. I've been throwing $50 at Lowe's. But Lowe's minimum payment $38, interest $26.47. What? Which means at the end of the day, I'm only paying them $11.53 towards a $1,000 bill. You know how long I'd be paying for this if I would get the minimum? And then my Visa card is embarrassing how much I owe. But the minimum payment is $303. The interest is $208. So what I'm throwing at it was less than $100, $94. So the financial freedom says to pay minimum payment on everything except your lowest bill. And with your lowest bill, throw all your extra money at. Like, pay the most you can pay to pay it off the quickest. And then when you do that, then you take that money and you throw it to after you pay that off, you take that money and you throw it to the next bill. After you pay that off, you take that money and you throw. I only got 3 steps for this, so I need to pay off Firestone. Because I'm not really counting the car, even though I'm going to pay the car off as normal. Well, almost normal. The last payment's supposed to be in December, but my last payment's going to be in November. So looking at that, I have three things paid off by my birthday. By the summer at the latest, but I'm shooting for my birthday to be done paid everybody off. I'm not going to plan any trips or anything. I got a few upcoming things right now that I've already been paid for or I've already obligated myself to pay for. But after that, I'm not paying for anything else extra. No more Goodwill hauls, none of that. It's strictly focusing on paying these three off. Once I pay these three off, then I could make my Visa payment plus take my car note payment, which is $260, and throw it at my Visa. So I'll be paying on the principal at least a good $360, if not more, to get that paid off quickly. So that being said, after I pay these three off, then I can go back to planning vacations and life as normal. So that's the plan. And I think that's a plan that I can work with.
I know, it's percolating and it smells awesome.
Yeah. It smells so good, I'm just going to stand right here and wait for it to finish. You know what I started to do is bring me some creamer, because I said I'm going to sit in here. Then my coffee would have been perfect.
They have creamer, don't they?
Yeah, but I don't like it. I have to use my creamer.
I'm telling you what time it ITE. So I just got all my swimming in. Look at my face. Oh my God, I was sitting in the sun and my face is so blotchy right now. Ew. But it's time to figure out a new hairdo. This hairdo is going to last a month. So it's going to take me about a week to make a decision. It is what it is. Okay, so this was just something to do because I had to grease my scalp. And my hairdo that I'm thinking about doing it for a month, this is kind of sort of pattern. Of course, I'm going to have to make it straighter, which is going to be a lot of fucking work. But I got the outline of what I think I want to do.
You into my fucking shit? Let's see if the righteous anger and fast forward to you explaining why you have an oxy prescription in the name of Bryce Walker.
Okay, look,
are you using it?
No, I don't believe you. I'm not.
Jesus Christ, I swear. You told me that the last time you saw Royce was at the end of summer. This prescription is from a month ago. You guys stayed in contact.